Welcome back. I'm Rod. I'm here with my dad,
Rod Senior,
and we are
Bridging the Gap.
Thanks for being here. If you like our videos, please make sure you hit that thumbs up. Also, drop a comment as to what album you think we should listen to next, and hit the notification bell so you can know every time we drop a new video. Dad, how's it going?
It's going pretty good.
Good.
How's it going with you today?
Hanging out. Ready to play another album for you.
All
right. So we last listened to Kanye West, The College Dropout.
Mm-hmm.
And how did you like that album?
I liked that album.
Yeah,
that was a really good album. And then the good thing of it was that after I listened to the album, I watched the documentary.
Yes.
And that was like, and then I could relate to the one song where he got, when he got injured.
Through the wire.
Yeah, through the wire. Yeah. So, but he just kept on talking about it a whole lot. You know, I was like, okay, dude, okay, we know you got injured now. Stop talking about it. So, anyway, but it was cool. Yeah. I liked the documentary.
Did you remember any of the songs that kind of stuck out to you or that they talked about in the documentary?
Yeah, through the wire. Through the wire,
yeah.
And then that one that had the little kids singing in the background. Mm-hmm. That was cool. I think that was the first song on the album, wasn't it?
Wow, boy. We don't care. So then, yeah, we don't care. Did you, you remember, I love the part with Jamie Foxx where goes to Jamie Foxx's house and they record slow jams. That's like my favorite.
That was a cool song right there, man. Yeah. Jamie Foxx, man, he just and the way they showed it in the documentary, man, it was just like he just fell in with the flow. It was just like natural. He didn't even have to think about what he was doing. Man, that was nice. That was real nice. Yeah.
Awesome. What did you think about like his relationship with his mom? Like,
oh man, that was kind of sad, you know. Because she was always there for everything for him. She was like, you know, when he was all down and out, I mean, that was like, you know, she would just a visit with his mom, or he talked to his mom, and it was like, she put all the life back into him. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And then kind of when she passed, it seemed as if his like life went into a spiral.
Yeah, it did.
Yeah.
It did. When she passed, man, he just, I don't think he had, he just couldn't handle it. He couldn't handle it, man. It was just like, I think he felt like he was all alone in the world, even with all the people around him. He felt alone.
Yeah.
He felt like he was helpless.
He felt vulnerable. It was a good story. The thing of it is now that I'm learning about Kanye and I saw the documentary, Kanye been dissed from the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
And now, even now, coming to the Grammys, mm-hmm. the upcoming mm-hmm. Grammys, they still trying to diss the brother.
Yeah.
And I'm like, really?
Yeah. He's always been an underdog and, had to fight through adversity. And I think that's why, so many people do relate to him, even when he's, you know, kind of going through it.
Yeah.
You know, everybody has some moments that they're not proud of and makes mistakes and has to overcome things. So.
Yeah, you know, the thing about it is to me, though, you keep dissing him, and all the dude does is he keeps coming back stronger.
Yeah.
Now, diss me all you want. I'm going to be a billionaire.
Yeah. For sure. All right. For sure. No, so, facts.
Yeah, diss me. I wish, people would diss me, and I could become a billionaire.
Right. Not such a bad gig then, huh?
Right.
Awesome. I guess we're going to just keep the Kanye Trey rolling for a little bit.
All right.
We're going to go ahead and listen to his second studio album. It was released in 2005. This is his follow-up album. And, like, this was, like, a lot of anticipation. People were really... Because, I mean, he came out of nowhere.
Right.
You know, with the College Dropout. And then, you know...
So they want to see what you got.
What's
next?
Your follow up? Yeah. Can you do it again? Like,
that's really kind of like the key right there.
For sure. Most people fall off after the first joint.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. But we'll go ahead and get into it. Just a little background. So Late Registration is his second studio album, and it was released on August 30th, 2005 through Def Jam Recordings and Rockefeller Records. So the same label there. He recorded over the course of a year during sessions held at studios in Hollywood and New York. So matching the College Dropout's commercial success, Late Registration debuted at number one. Sold 860,000 copies in the first week. That's dope. Wow. It's a certified quadruple platinum, and it's got a few really awesome singles that I feel like you probably should have heard at least one or two of these, but we'll see. Let's get right into it. So the opening track here is Wake Up Mr. West, and then it rolls right into Heard 'Em Say.
So I'll just let that play.
All right. I hope this is good.
Also, I'm not even going to tell you what the singles are. I'm going to just see if you can like spot them.
All right.
All right. All right. Wake Up Mr. West and right into Heard 'Em Say. Featuring Adam Levine.
Adam Levine.
Yeah, you know who that is?
Yeah, he's a country singer.
Kinda. He's like a pop singer.
Yeah, he's a country singer. At least I thought. That's where
He's like a judge on one of them talent shows, yeah, and he was in Maroon 5.
Yeah, yeah.
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 So Wake Up Mr. West. D-Ray is back on this joint. So he was the comedian on the on the previous album. Here we go.
Is that the one that sounded like Bernie Mac?
Knew I was gonna see you again. Where you got damn book bag at? I was carrying that little book bag. Nobody wanna see that. That damn fourth grader. Put your ass down. You don't wanna play the game like he got something else to do. You don't got nothing else to do. You ain't doing nothing with your life. Nothing with your life. What you think this is? Oh, you better look at me, I'm talking to you.
That's kind of nice.
You think this is easy, don't you? You think this is promise? You ain't nothing promised to you. Look at my face. Do I got a promise face? You look like I promise you anything. Kanye, Nick, did you snow in my class? Wake up, Mr. West. Wake up, Mr. West. Mr. West. Mr. West.
Didn't expect that.
Yeah. And I heard him say, nothing's ever promised tomorrow today. From the shy like Tim, it's a harder way. So this is in the name of love, like Robert said. Before you ask me to go get a job today, can I at least get a raise on the minimum wage? And I know the government administer AIDS, so I guess we just pray like the ministers say. Alu Akbar and throwing some hot car. And I heard him say, nothing's ever promised tomorrow today. But we'll find a way.
In harmony?
Yeah.
That was nice.
Say people in your life for seasons, and anything that happen is for a reason. And niggas gun clapping and keep the squeezing, and Graham keep praying and keep believing in Jesus, and one day that should see him. Till then walk in his footsteps and try to be him. The devil is alive, I feel him breathing. Claiming money is the key, so keep on dreaming, and put them lottery tickets just to tease us. My Aunt Pam can't put them cigarettes down, so now my little cousin smoking them cigarettes now. His job try to claim that he too niggerish now. It's because the skin blacker than licorice now. I can't figure it out. I'm sticking it now. And I heard him say, nothing's ever promised tomorrow today. And I heard him say, nothing's ever promised tomorrow today. But we'll find a way.
Then Adam Levine is going down.
Okay. Yeah, that's crazy.
I can listen to this every day right
there. Yeah.
That's one of those songs to start your day with.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Get up in the morning, pop it on. While you in the shower or something, you know, or in the car.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, that is mag nasty right there. The way they ended that, well, was that like a saxophone or something like that? And oh man,
all right, percussions. That was track number two. Heard Him Say, followed by, I mean, the intro first, and then that song. How'd you like that one?
you know, I'm not gonna judge the whole album right now, but just from them the first two cuts,
yeah,
dude, he smashed the first
one. It's already a classic.
he smashed his first album already with the first two songs on this one.
Oh, you think so?
And because I mean, that sounds more like my kind of stick, you know.
Okay.
I don't know, we'll see. Maybe I'm jumping to conclusions. So let's go. Let's see what the rest of it brings.
Well, I definitely think it's worth it to note that like all of his albums sound different. And it's really, I think that's unique of an artist to make so many different sounding albums. Most people kind of stick to the same thing.
And you know their music is probably the same. Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Yeah, exactly. They stick to what they know. And for somebody to just continue to evolve a sound, Kanye's got like one of the best discographies for that. But anyway,
man, that piano was just like when he first come in, you know, my boy fake Bernie Mac.
Yeah.
And then they came in with it. And then Adam Levine was going, ooh.
Yeah.
Oh man, that was like, that was nice.
Yeah, word. I'm glad you was feeling that one.
Definitely.
All right, cool. So we'll go ahead and roll into the next track. This is track number 3 on Late Registration.
Glad all these rappers.
Oh, yeah.
Who'd have thought?
I got you something. Hold on.
Who'd have thought? You got me buying rap music.
Okay, so we'll go ahead and move right into track number 3. This is called Touch the Sky. It's featuring a rapper by the name of Lupe Fiasco. And this one is produced by Kanye West and Just Blaze. If you remember, Just Blaze produced a couple of the songs on Jay-Z's album that we listened to, the Black Album. Mm-hmm. Very popular with the soul sound, those soul samples, just like Kanye was. They kind of had a similar time at this.
Those are one of my favorites on Jay-Z's album.
Yeah.
The ones he was.
The Just Blaze ones? Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure. All right, cool. So we'll go ahead and get right into Touch the Sky. Here we go.
I gotta testify, come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Gotta testify, come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Back when they thought pink polos would hurt the rock, before Cam got the shit to pop, the doors is closed. I felt like Bad Boy Street Team, I couldn't work the lock club. At least about an hour I stand online, I just wanted to dance. I went to Jacob an hour after I got my
advance.
I just wanted to shine.
Yeah.
Jay's favorite line, dog.
Screaming at you, man.
Now they look at me like, damn, dog, you what I am. A hip hop legend, I think I died in an accident, cause this must be heaven. I gotta testify, come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky.
It sounds like kind of like one of Jay-Z's songs.
Yeah, for sure. That style.
Back in Gucci with the shit to rock. Back when Slick Rick got the shit to pop. I'd do anything to say I got it.
Big Kanye can't rap.
He be blowing, man, dude.
KFC. Dog, I was having nervous breakdowns. Like, man, these niggas that much better than me. Baby, I'm going on an airplane, and I don't know if I'll be back again. Sure enough, I sent the plane tickets, but when she came to kick it, things became different. Any girl I cheated on, she skeeted on. Couldn't keep it at home. Thought I needed a knee alone. I'm trying to right my wrongs, but it's funny them same wrongs help me write the song. Man, I gotta testify. Come up in the spot,
looking extra fly. He's clowning, man.
For the day you die, you gon' touch the sky, you gon' touch the sky, yeah. Baby girl, test herb. Peach fuzz, buzz, but bit on the verge. Let's slow it down like river on the serve. Bottle shaped body like Mrs. Butterworth. But before you say another word, I'm back on the block like I'm laying on the street. I'm trying to stop lying like a mum rob, but I'm not lying when I'm laying on the beat. On God, a touche, Lupe, cool as the unthaw, but I still feel possessed as a gunshot. The cover's a porn star, and the best pair steps and my best phone call. So I represent the first. Now let me end my verse right where the horns are. Like, I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day you die, you gon' touch the sky. You gon' touch the sky, baby girl. Testify.
All Right, that is track number 3, Touch the Sky, produced by Just Blaze and Kanye West. What did you think about that one, Dad?
I love that. That horn section?
Yeah.
It was just killer, man. Yeah. And Kanye, man, he just... The boy can rap.
Yeah, he be rapping. He be spitting.
He can spit, man. I was like, oh.
For sure.
He was coming at you, man. He's like, it sound like, he makes you feel like, to me, when he was rapping there, he make you feel like he's all in that mic saying, yeah, I'm going to show y'all I can rap. You know what I mean? Yeah, he's just going at it hard. You know
trying
what
to prove
mean?
A point.
Yeah. That was good, man. That was good stuff right there.
Dope. What'd you think about the feature verse by Lupe Fiasco?
The feature verse?
Yeah.
That was good.
That third verse on there, Lupe.
Oh, yeah. That was the one that first, when he started just really getting my attention right there. I was like, ah. And the bottle-shaped body like Mrs. Buzzerworth.
Yeah. I just love that line. Or Touche Lupe as the young thought. Yep. But I still feel possesses a gun charge. Like, oh, man. He that little pocket he hit was just crazy.
Yeah.
So that's actually the first time Lupe Fiasco made like an appearance in the rap game, like on a big level.
Mm-hmm.
So Kanye put him on with this one, and then he later, 1 year later, produced to me one of the best hip hop albums out.
Lupe
did.
Really?
Yeah. A year after this, he released Food and Liquor, and we absolutely have to listen to Food and Liquor. I love that album. Lupe is a really good rapper.
Yeah, he is.
Like a really good rapper. Like his wordplay and, yeah, he's crazy. But anyway, I digress.
Mad flow. Huh?
We'll get to that one. We'll have to definitely play that. All right, so we'll go ahead and move into this. Okay,
so far this has surprised me because I thought this was going to bore me. I don't know why. I was like, because after I heard that last Kanye record, the album, it was good. I was like, oh, that's good. But then you said, oh, we doing Kanye again. I was like, okay. I hope it's not boring now.
Yeah.
Because like you said, it really, that's a test to most artists. After you put a good first one out and then come back and do a second one, it's usually like a bummer. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. Our subscribers really want us to go on the full Kanye journey. And,
is that right?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
And I think we'll like eventually do that, but I definitely wanted to play you like these, at least the first three.
Right.
Because they're just like the holy trinity in the rap game. Like, I don't
is
know.
That right?
I feel like.
Yeah.
But yeah, we'll go ahead and get into track number 4. This is called Gold Digger featuring Jamie Foxx. There is absolutely no way you've never heard this song.
No way. I don't know.
You've absolutely heard this song.
I don't know.
Okay. Gold Digger.
Gold Digger. All right.
She take my money.
Well, I already know that. Yeah.
Right.
That's that song Bill Cosby used to play, right?
Oh, Gold
Digger.
Yeah.
Now I ain't saying she a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke niggas.
Yeah,
I ain't saying she a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke niggas.
Bill Cosby played this in one of his
episodes. Yeah.
That's why I first heard it.
The Ray Charles song?
Yeah.
Get down, girl, go ahead, get down. Get down, girl, go ahead. Cutie the bomb, met her at a beauty salon with a baby Louis Vuitton under her underarm. She said, I could tell you rock, I could tell by your charm. Fars, girls, you got a flock, I could tell by your charm and your arm. But I'm looking for the one, have you seen her? My psychic told me she have an ass like Serena, Trina, Gina for Lopez. 4 kids and I gotta take all they badass to show biz. She got a baby by Buster. My best friend said she used to fuck with Usher. I don't care what none of y'all say, I still love her.
Dang.
I ain't saying she a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke niggas. Now I ain't saying she a gold digger. His baby mama car crib is bigger than his. You will see him on TV any given Sunday. Win a Super Bowl and drive off in a Hyundai. She was supposed to buy your shorty Tyco with your money. She went to the doctor, got lipo with your money. She walk around looking like Michael with your money. Should've got that insured Geico for your money. If you ain't no punk, holla, we want prenup. We want prenup.
Yeah.
It's something that you need to have. Cause when she leave your ass, she gon' leave with half. 18 years, 18 years. And on her 18th birthday, found out it wasn't his.
Oh, now,
she a gold digger. But she ain't messing with no broke niggas. And they gon' keep calling and trying, but you stay right, girl. And when he get on, he leave your ass for a white girl. Get down, girl, gon' head, get down. Get down, girl, gon' head, get down. Get down, girl, gon' head. Let me hear that back.
All right, that's gold to hear about Kanye West. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
I don't know. For some reason, I liked it better this time. I've heard it before.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But when I seen the words, then it was like, okay. Yeah, it was good. That was a good song.
Yeah, it's definitely one of Kanye's funnier songs.
He had fun with that.
Yeah. Kanye's a funny dude. He throws in the little lines and songs, and then sometimes he'll do a full song. It's just like, every line is just hilarious. But all right, cool. That's a gold digger. You heard that before.
Right.
But it's, it is different, like, when you actually, like, are, I guess, paying attention.
Right.
All right. So we'll go ahead and roll into track number 5. This is skit number 1, produced by Kanye West. D-Ray Davis again. Here we go.
Oh, okay.
I brought you brothers here today to start our own fraternity. Broke five broke. We ain't got
broke
it.
Five broke five broke.
Hold on. So I'm just going to let it roll into the next song, which is Drive Slow. Okay. So skit 1.
I brought you brothers here today to start our own fraternity. Broke five broke. Broke five we ain't broke. Got it. Broke five broke.
We ain't got it.
No, we have no money. We are sharing jeans. If I
sharing
go outside,
jeans.
I got the only clothing on.
For no gas. Say it. We can't afford no gas.
So we ain't driving.
That's crazy.
All right, so we'll go ahead and roll into the next track, which is track number 5. Track number 6, Drive Slow. This was featuring Paul Wall and GLC. GLC is a rapper that we heard on Kanye's last album. He had a verse on Spaceship. He had one of the verses on Spaceship.
Okay.
But anyway, the other rapper is Paul Wall. Around this time, there's like this big movement from Houston happening. And it's rappers like Paul Wall, Slim Thug, Mike Jones, Chamillionaire. And they're making like all this noise from Houston. Houston wasn't like really popping for like big music, mm-hmm. like that was making a lot of noise. So Kanye went and grabbed Paul Wall and threw him on his track. And I think that's actually pretty dope if you just think about it in the context of hip hop, like, because that was going on. Kanye peeped it. Paul Wall,
he's
I need
just
you
on
this.
Top of everything.
Yeah, 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 for sure.
Oh, okay.
So I just wanted to point that out real quick. Drive Slow, track number 6, Late Registration, produced by Kanye West. Here we go.
Drive slow, homie. Drive slow, homie. You never know, homie. Might meet some hoes, homie. You need to pump your brakes and drive slow, homie. My homie Molly used to stay 79th mate. One of my best friends from back in the day. Down the street from Calumet, a school full of stones. He nicknamed me K-Rock, so there, leave me alone. Bulls jacket with his hat broke way off. And walked around the mall with his radio face off. Plus he had a spinner from his Dayton's in his hand. Keys in his hand, reason again to let you know he's the man. They're all wavy. Hit Lakeshore, girls go all crazy. Hit the freeway, go at least about 80. Bone so much that summer, even had him a baby. See, back then, if you had a car, you was the Chi-Town version of baby, and I was just a virgin of baby. One of the reasons I looked up to him crazy and left my trunk waving. The candy gloss is immaculate, simply amazing. The male bows poking wide on the Cadillac trunk, open screens on, neons lit with fifth relax. I'm on a mission for dime pieces and sexy ladies. Allow me to introduce you to my CL Mercedes. It's a star studded event when I valet park. Open up my mouth in sunlight, illuminates the dark. You see them foes crawling, you see them screens falling. The disco ball in my mouth insinuates I'm bowling. I'm leaning on the switch, sitting
it in my slab, but I can still catch boppers if I drove a cab.
Right.
A young Houston hard hitter, all about the Skrilla, riding some candy coated, crawling like a caterpillar. I'm tipping on them foes, I'm jamming on this group. I'm looking for them hoes, baby, what it do? Try slow, homie. Turn your hazard lights on when you see them hoes. Drive slow, homie.
Take your hazard lights.
If you're riding around the city with nowhere to go. Drive slow, homie. Homie, drive slow, drive slow, drive slow.
They ain't playing.
Slow, homie. Drive slow, homie.
Slow.
You never know, homie. Might meet some hoes, homie. You need to pump your brakes and drive slow, homie. Drive slow, homie.
All right, that is Drive Slow featuring
Paul
Wall
and GLC. I like the way they ended that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was cool. I like that song. That was cool. Your boy,
Paul Wall.
Paul Wall.
Mm-hmm.
Paul Wall's cool with his, ain't he?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, he can rap.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's a new one for me.
Yeah, that's Paul that Houston Wall. Houston style.
Houston style. Mm-hmm. All right. All right.
Yeah, lots of just braggadocious lyrics, kind of stunting. They always talk about their grills and their old school whips.
Yeah, yeah. He's talking about the Vogues
and everything. Yeah, yeah. I was like, oh, listen to them. My screen fall and my trunk, my Jesus trunk wave. Chain. Yeah, yeah, yeah. For sure. No, they killed that. And at that end where they slowed the music down, that's actually something that they do in the Houston style of music. It's called Screw. So they record tracks regular and then they slow them down and then put a bunch of chops in it. Like they like bring it back and like repeat parts.
Okay.
And that's called screw music. And it's just indicative of that region because they just like pour up lean, sip syrup. They talk about the syrup sipping and stuff.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And everything's slow while you're slipping syrup. Mm-hmm. So that's why you want your music screwed up.
Slow down, homie.
All right, screwed up.
Gotcha.
All right, cool.
Okay, I got school today.
Yeah. A little bit. So I don't know. Maybe I'll play some screw music for you sometime.
All right.
The next song is called "My Way Home" by Common, or featuring Common.
Common.
Yeah, and you liked what Common did on Kanye's last album.
Yep.
And a lot of these subscribers have suggested that we listen to Common's album entitled "B." It was released around this time. Kanye pretty much produced the whole thing. Common and Kanye have worked closely for a long time. So
Kanye produced Common's album.
Yep.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. And it's a really dope album. I think you'd like it a lot. Mm. So maybe we can get to that at some point in time. This one is "My Way Home," produced by Kanye West and featuring Common. Here we go. This one's dope. It's got the Gil Scott hair.
They got some Gil Scott hair on here.
Yeah.
Oh, that's my boy there.
Oh, no. Check this out.
Yeah.
I'm on my way home.
They say home is where the hate is. My dome is where fate is. I stroll where souls get lost like Vegas. Seen through the eyes of rebel glasses. Pray to God that my arms reach the masses. The young smoke grass in grassless jungles. Oh, don't he know he could only get as high as he fell? Show money becomes bail. Relationships become jail. Children are unhailed. I wish love was for sale. He hold the bail. Horse got me trapped like R. Kelly. I bail and it
might not be such a bad idea if I never
die. You crazy.
Never went home again.
No.
Children are unheld.
Home is filled with pain and it might not be such a bad idea if I never went home again.
Deep message right there.
All right, so that's "My Way Home" featuring Common. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
That was a deep message right there. That was he said a lot in just that one verse where they were talking about being in jail and children unheld.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Show money becomes bail. Relationships become jail. Yeah. Children are unheld. Oh, man, that bar right there was crazy.
It was. That's a lot to think about. If you just sat back and thought about just that line right there, man, he's like, damn, that was a good song.
Yeah, yeah, that's a lot of meaning in that song. And then what did you think about the Gil Scott Heron sample on there?
I love Gil Scott Heron.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. Are we familiar with that particular record?
No, not that particular one, but I got a lot of Gil Scott Heron, man. Mm-hmm. I tell you what, man, but I love his voice. It's so unique.
Yeah, it's very unique. Mm-hmm. You can just spot it as soon as you hear it. Mm-hmm. Home is Where the Hatred Is by Gil Scott Heron.
That's just deep, man, right there. Home is Where the Hatred Is?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Okay.
All right, cool. So, yeah, Common delivered there on a verse.
Common,
yeah,
yeah, Common, your boy Common. I would like to hear some of his music
for sure.
Yeah,
I think you're really gonna enjoy that album. All right, we'll go ahead and move into the next song. This is track number eight,
music,
track number eight featuring The Game.
What the hell is crack music? I gotta hear this.
Yeah, crack music is featuring The Game. Do you know who The Game is? Have you ever heard that name before?
Yeah, I've heard that name before. I can't, you know, because you always say, you remember this, you remember that. I'm like, dude, you've been throwing so much stuff at me. I kind of remember.
Yeah, that's okay. I think after, like, because people appear on other stuff. And then, right. You know, I just think over time it'll,
the
like.
The Game.
The Game. So he hasn't actually appeared on anything that we listened to, but he's affiliated with one of the artists that we've listened to. He used to be on G-Unit with 50 Cent. So he was part of 50 Cent's crew at one point in time. Mm. Then they fell out, and then they had beef.
Really?
And they were beefing with each other for a long, long time. 50 Cent Game. It's one of, like,
man, you start beefing with 50 Cent, that shit gone for the next forever 30 years.
Exactly.
Are they still beefing?
I think they've kind of made up. I don't know. They be like beefing and then they'll hang out and then they stop and start beefing again.
It's like a love hate
relationship. Yeah, yeah, yeah. But they were going at each other hard back in the day. Like, once Game got kicked out of G-Unit, it was all kind of stuff. All kind of stuff involved with that. We're gonna have to listen to some G-Unit too.
All right,
but anyway, this is a Game at this time. He's really, really popular. He's at the height of his popularity, so Kanye threw him on this joint, Crack Music. But it's dope that he kind of used him as just a hook, kind of like what he did with Ludacris on Breathe In, Breathe Out on the last album. So here we go.
All right, cool.
That's that crack music, nigga. That real black music, nigga. That's that crack music, nigga. That real black music, nigga. How we stopped the Black Panthers. Ronald Reagan cooked up an answer. You hear that? What Gil Scott was hearing. When our heroes and heroines got clipped on heroin crack. Raised the murder rate in D.C. and Maryland. We invested in that. It's like we got Merrill Lynched. And we've been hanging from the same tree ever since. Sometimes I feel the music is the only medicine. So we cook it, cut it, measure it, bag it, sell it. The fiends cop it.
Damn.
Nowadays they can't tell it. That's that good shit. We ain't sure,
that's
man.
A serious metaphor. Like,
yeah, that's pure, man. Back in the hood, it's a different type of chemical. Arm and Hammer, baked soda. Raised they whole quota. Right when our soldiers ran for the stove. Cuz, dreams of being hope. And went from being a broke man to being a dope man to being a president. Look, there's hope, man. God, how could you let this happen? Happen.
Oh. Nice. That's real.
Yeah.
Crack music, nigga. That real black music, nigga.
Yeah.
soul bullshit. And to atone, I throw a little something, something on the pulpit. I'm a slave's trade hooks for Grammys.
Wow.
This dark diction has become America's addiction. Those who ain't even black use it. We gonna keep bagging up this here crack music.
Damn.
Crack Music featuring The Game, produced by Kanye West. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Kanye's a genius, dude. I mean, who would think to think about music and put it in the context that he did to make it, he compared it to crack,
right.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, that was ingenious, man. I tell you, is the way his mind operates,
mm-hmm.
I can respect that, you know? And as I was watching the documentary, back to the documentary, I was thinking to myself, they don't understand him.
They don't get it.
They don't get. They're not getting it, man. And then he gets upset. Now his drawback is he gets so freaking upset because he's so impatient with people because they don't understand.
Right,
him.
Right.
You know
right.
what I mean? And he just blows up, man. Sometimes I think his head was gonna explode. He'd be so pissed off. You know what I mean? And he'll just go off on a tangent. You know?
Yeah.
And I'm just like, hey, you know, but I feel it. I feel him. You know. I see where he's coming from, because if I was in his position, many times, knowing me, I would be doing exactly what they'd be thinking. Oh, he crazy. He crazy. But anyway, that was a good song, man. Really, really, really deep, just as the other song was. But, man, he just keeps it coming.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. I'm glad you picking up on all of that. And I think it is cool that you saw the documentary, because just kind of gives you a little bit more insight, you know,
of who he
of
was.
Who he is. Yeah. Yeah, and it had some really dope vocals. They had Game on that hook that kind of like brought his like raspy voice. And
mm-hmm.
Then you had
that choir.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Tony Williams. I guess they also had background vocals by Keisha Cole and Charlie Wilson.
Mm.
Yeah. Okay. Charlie Wilson is a frequent collaborator of Kanye West, too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I know you like Charlie Wilson, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Everybody was so weak at you going at John Legend. There was some people that was like, yeah.
What?
John Legend. When you I was talking about John Legend on the last
video. What'd they say?
Some people agreed with you.
And then some people
And then didn't. Some people was just laughing at it. It was just like, damn, your dad had all that smoke for John Legend.
Yeah, that's not my guy.
I'm weak. That's so funny.
Sorry, John.
That's
not my guy.
That was really funny. All right, we'll go ahead and roll to the next track. This is track number 9. It's titled Roses, and this is produced by John Breon and Kanye West. And
that's a new name too, right?
Yeah, I think he actually produced some of the other stuff. I don't on this album. So Kanye is a super collaborative producer. He always brings in other producers to help bring his vision out. He also is a collaborative writer.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of these songs, he does get a lot of writing help as well.
He gets around a lot from what I could see on the documentary.
Uh-huh.
Man, this dude just like, he just gets, I'm in a city this morning, I'm in another city this afternoon.
Mm-hmm.
And I see that it seems like that he does his homework.
Yeah.
He keeps his ear attuned to all what everybody is doing around the country.
Absolutely.
And then he just like, okay, I need this guy right here. Mm-hmm. I need this guy right here. And that's the way he does it. But he gets unique people.
Yeah.
And they're good.
Right.
So that's what I've noticed about him.
For sure. Definitely. All right. We'll roll right into Roses. Here we go.
I know it's past visiting hours, but can I please give her these flowers? The doctor don't want to take procedures. He claimed my heart can't take the anesthesia. It'll send her body into a seizure. The little thing by the hospital bed, it'll stop beeping. Hey, chick, I'm at a loss for words. What do you say at this time? Remember when I was 9? Tell her everything gonna be fine, but I be lying. The family crying. They want her to live, and she trying. I'm arguing like, what kind of doctor can we find? You know the best medicine go to people that's paid. If Magic Johnson got a cure for AIDS, and all the broke motherfuckers passed away. You telling me if my grandma's in the NBA, right now she'd be okay. But since she was just a secretary, worked for the church for 35 years, things supposed to stop right here. My grandfather trying to pull it together. He's strong. That's where I get my confidence from. Asked the nurse, did you do the research? She asked me, can you sign some t-shirts?
Bitch, is you smoking reefer? You don't see that we hurt, but still.
I smile.
Deal with us.
Emergency room, you can feel my heartbeat, beat, beat. If she gon' pull through, we gon' find out soon. But right now, she sleep, sleep, sleep. My mama say,
it's the sunshine.
All right, that is track number 9, Roses, featuring Patti LaBelle, Bill Withers.
Bill Withers, yeah.
What did you think about that one, Dad?
That was really nice, super nice. I love the message. To me, when I was listening to it, I was like,
yeah.
It was, and the music in it was just like, it was beautiful.
Mm-hmm. I guess there was his grandmother had a near death experience, mm-hmm. and this is kind of him just explaining that,
was,
you know,
together, yeah, and mm-hmm. it was like, yeah, and they were the roses,
yeah,
the family were the roses,
yeah,
you know, so that was nice,
yeah,
it was well done.
What'd you think about the Bill Withers sample? Are you familiar?
Man, I love Bill Withers,
yeah,
I love Bill Withers. Patti LaBelle, you know, it's an mm-hmm. old school folk.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Cool. All right, we'll go ahead and roll into track number 10. This one is titled Bring Me Down. This is featuring Brandy.
Brandy?
Yeah, you know Brandy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Produced by Kanye West and John Breon. And here we go. It's kind of Kanye going at his haters.
Oh, is that right? Oh, okay. Brandy can blow.
Yeah. Bring me down.
I always knew that one day they try to bring me down, way down, way down.
I have to say, since Pac passed away, most you rappers don't even deserve a track from me. You Whoa. See, if you ever wanted to ever be anything, it'd always be somebody that'll shoot down any dream. Yeah. It'd always be haters, that's the way it is. Hating niggas marry hated bitches and have hated kids. They don't have to take my drive. When I was barely living, that's what kept me alive. Just a thought
like
that
you.
Maybe it could be better than what we at this time. Make it out of this grind, for I'm out of my mind. And get some leeway on it, he say, she say. Your girl don't like me, how long has she been gay? Spanish girls say, you know, I play English. And everybody wanna run to me for they single. It's funny how these whack niggas need my help. Running around when I couldn't feed myself. Yeah. Dog, advise you, I wouldn't feel myself. Dog, advise you, I'd kill myself.
Damn.
Made a meal myself, and I'm still myself. And I'ma look in the mirror if I need some help. Now I'm speaking on y'all all fun. Everybody
complain
about K, but at least y'all feel something. Feel something.
What you call me? I've been on it, forget it, once I'm get, forget you.
that is Bring Me Down featuring Brandy. What do you think about that one, Dad?
I love that song. So it is so real, that song, man. Yeah. It's like, it's real talk right there.
Uh-huh.
So he and then I like when he said, what was it? He said, everybody's always looking for his help. But then, you know, where were they when he couldn't feed himself?
Right, right, right.
And then
right,
he said,
right.
If he need help, he got to look in the mirror.
Right.
Oh, he got to look in the mirror if he needs help.
Right.
Like, I help myself.
Right, you right. Know?
That was tight.
Yeah.
That was tight. And that Brandy hook in there.
Uh-huh.
Oh, dude, it was.
What'd you think about the instrumentation, all those pianos and strings?
Yeah, he uses a lot of pianos and strings, and that's, I love music that got a lot of pianos and strings, and I love my violins.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so yeah. He uses all of that. He don't go with the usual rap stuff like the snares. Mm-hmm. I mean, he does use it, but a lot of them, that's their kind of their bass. That's their
main sound.
Main sound,
right.
That snare. But he doesn't use a lot of that.
Yeah.
And another thing I've noticed about Kanye is that differentiates him from some of the other rappers is he's not talking about a whole bunch of killing,
mm-hmm.
and you know, stuff like that. Now he will talk about real life, you know, things that go on in the hood and just real life stuff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Not only in the hood, but everywhere.
Right.
But you know, he's just like not a whole lot of bang bang shoot 'em up kind of stuff.
For sure.
You know. So.
Absolutely. Cool. Well, yeah, I really like that song.
That's a good song.
Just kind of, I like the hated niggas, marry hated bitches and have hated kids.
Hell yeah, that's right. That's right. That was crazy right there.
That was a funny line. Yeah, you having a little funny. A
lot
little,
of like, truth to that.
Yeah,
too.
I know, man.
A lot of truth.
Exactly. For real. That's why I be so funny, because it's true.
Yeah.
Facts. All right. Don't be a hater, kids. All right. We'll go ahead and roll into the next track. This is track number 11, Addiction, produced by Kanye West and John Breon.
So we got a crack one, and now we got an addiction.
Yeah.
Okay.
Crack music. Yeah, here we go.
Etta James.
Etta James sample here.
Snap.
Yeah. He's a man. He be in a sampling bag. He be sampling the joints, and then it make me want to go and listen to the original song, because a lot of times too, like when people sample stuff, they only like, they'll just sample like the popular part of that mm-hmm. song that everybody will recognize,
right.
But Kanye will find like the one little line in a verse, or you know what I mean, and sample that part,
right,
and it's
right.
Like, dang, when you hear that and you actually listen to the original and you hear that part, it's like, damn, okay. I would have never picked that part though
right.
to loop, you
right.
know.
But he knows how to listen, man. Yeah. He's got a keen ear, man.
Keen ear. Like,
he has a keen sense of talent too, man.
For
I tell you. Oh man.
For sure. Here we go.
All right.
Addiction.
I see why you like it.
It's like layers to it,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Why everything that's supposed to be bad make me feel so good? Everything they told me not to is exactly what I would. Man, I tried to stop, man, I tried the best I could, but
you make me smile.
What's your addiction? Is it money? Is it girls? Is it weed? I've been afflicted by not one, not two, but all three. She's got the same thing about me, but more about us. She's coming over, so I guess that means I'm a drug never over.
Why everything's supposed to be bad make me feel so good? Everything they told me not to is exactly what I would. Man, I tried to stop,
like,
man, I tried the best I could, but
he always got those nice little touches. Uh-huh.
Make me smile with my heart.
Why everything that's supposed to be bad make me feel so good? Everything they told me not to is exactly what I would. Man, I tried to stop, man, I tried the best I could, but let's say, your friends, remember the one, huh? You said if you ever, she would be the one. Well, I was thinking, hypothetically, I mean, don't take this seriously. Don't take me, I mean, just, not credibly, I feel it incredibly. Let's let it be, I just let it be. I mean, you hurting me, I mean, you hurting me. Maybe, baby, 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 baby. You know I was just kidding.
Unless you're gonna do it. I like Nelly, right?
Unless you're gonna do it.
I'll let you go do it.
Yeah.
All right, that's Addiction by Kanye West. What do you think about that one?
I like that song, man. I like all the little soft touches he put in the song.
Mm-hmm.
That was really nice. Addiction.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yep. All right. 1 second. All right, we'll go ahead and roll right into the next track here. This is track number 12. This is skit number 2, and then it goes into Diamonds from Sierra Leone. And
okay.
So Diamonds from Sierra Leone. Oh, it's the remix is on here. Featuring Jay-Z. Is that how it's supposed to go? Diamonds from Sierra Leone featuring Jay-Z. That's interesting that the remix is the first time that this song appears on this album, but.
What do you mean?
Well, because I don't know why the remix would come first, because I feel like the original song should come first.
Hmm.
And I'm trying to think, because I used to have a CD, but I don't remember. If you had the CD of Late Registration, did the original version of Diamonds come first or no? Commenters, let us know. But anyway, so we'll just play it the way it comes here. So featuring Jay-Z, produced by Devo something. I don't know. Kanye West and John Breon. So let's get to first.
All right.
We broke, 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 five broke. We ain't got it. Broke, 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 five broke. We ain't got it. Don't spend no money, ain't got no clothes. Broke, broke, broke. Bunch of niggas broke, 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 broke.
They cracking me over that broke, five broke. That's funny to me, man. Oh, man.
Diamonds are forever. They are.
Throw your diamonds in the sky if you feel the vibe. The rock is still alive every time I rhyme. Forever, ever, forever, ever, 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 ever.
That same has like a James Bond feel, you know,
for sure. Absolutely. Could be like a movie score.
Right.
People lose hands, legs, arms for real. Little was known as Sierra Leone and how we connect to the diamonds we own. When I speak of diamonds in this song, I ain't talking about the ones that be glown. I'm talking about Rockefeller, my home, my chain. These ain't conflict diamonds. Is they Jacob? Don't lie to me, man. People asking me is I'm gonna get my chain back. That'll be the same day I get a game back. You know the next questions are, yo, where Dame at? Let's track the Indian dance to bring our rain back. What's up with you and Jay, man? Are y'all okay, man?
Yep. I got it from here, yay, damn. The chain remains, the gang is intact. The name is mine, I'll take blame for that. The pressure's on, but guess who ain't gonna crack? Pardon me, I had to laugh at that. How could you falter when you're the rock at Gibraltar? I had to get off the boat so I could walk on water. This ain't no tall order, this is nothing to me. Difficult takes a day, impossible takes a week. I do this in my sleep. I sold kilos of coke. I'm guessing I could sell CDs. I'm not a businessman, I'm a businessman. Let me handle my business. Damn, Kanye's, you got me. Freeway to Foxy, YG's, Tierra Marie.
Damn.
PD, watch me. Bleak could be one hit away.
Jay-Z.
As long as I'm alive, he's a millionaire. And even if a guy's in my will somewhere.
That sound like a big production, kind of, like you said, a movie.
Score.
Yeah. Yeah. That was good. Jay-Z, man, he came in and he just killed it.
Yeah.
He did. He killed it, man. And just think, Jay-Z, the type of rapper he is, he could have took that verse and kept going on and on and on and on and on. Sure. You know, because he's that kind of rapper. Man, that was a nice song. That was a good song.
Yeah.
You know. Man, these guys are creative. This is like a real classy rap. I thought I'd never say that. It's a classy rap album.
You were, for sure.
What?
Definitely.
I said that.
I like that. I like it. It is a very classy rap album. I agree. All right, this is my absolute favorite song from this album. It's called We Major. It is track number 14. Featuring Really Doe and Nas. You remember Nas, right?
Yeah, I remember Nas.
Yep, and it's produced by John Breon, Warren Campbell, and Kanye West. Track 14, We Major. Man. It's that joint. All right, here we go.
Listen to that. So nice.
You motherfuckers better do your job and roll up and watch how we roll up and I can't control it, can't hold it, it's so nuts. I take a sip of that yak, I wanna fuck. I take a hit of that chronic, it got me stuck.
We major, come on. Feeling better than some head on a Sunday afternoon. Better than a chick that say yes too soon. Until you have a daughter, that's what I call karma. And you pray to God she don't grow breasts too soon. Projects toe up, gang signs are stone up. Niggas hats broke off, that's how we grow up. Why else you think shorties write rhymes just to blow up? Get they first car on that IRS show.
Now pimp and get your paper high off the ground instead of skyscraper. Cool out, thinking we local. Come on, homie, we major.
We major. Come on, homie, we major.
We major.
Come on, homie, we major.
We major.
Come on, homie, we major.
We major.
Come on, homie, we major. I heard the beat and I ain't know what to write. First line, should it be about the holes of the ice? Four foes of black Christ, both flows would be nice. Rap about big paper on the black man flight. At the studio console, ask my man to the right. What this verse sound like? Should I freestyle or write? He said, Nas, what the fans want is ill. Matic still, looked at your pad and pencil and jotted what I feel. Game took, either way, my change came like Sam Cooke. Yeah.
Feeling better than I ever felt before today. A better link than ever beat. Orientation. Think we can make it better, throwing all your cares away.
They gonna do a little pruning on them.
Better do your job and roll up and watch how we roll up.
Can I talk my shit again? Can I talk my shit again?
Okay.
I can't believe I'm back up in this motherfucker. I'ma be late though. I gotta figure out what I'm gonna wear. Yeah. On the vocal. Sweet. It seems quite beautiful, don't you agree?
Yeah.
Don't you agree?
I agree.
John Bryan on the keys right now, and Warren Campbell on the keys right now. So they ask me, why you calling late registration, yeah? 'Cause we taking these motherfuckers back.
tight. Oh, man. That's talent. That is talent. I'm gonna be all day.
All right, that is We Major.
That was Mac Nasty.
Yeah. We got the certified Mac Nasty. Yeah. I think that's how I know like a song is like a real, real banger to you is when we get the Mac Nasty.
Mac Nasty.
That's the stamp of approval. drop Mac Nasty in the comments.
That song, man, it's like he had a hook in there where it said, throw all your cares away.
Yeah.
That song illuminates that feeling, you know what I mean?
Oh, man.
Because it's like, just like when you listen to it, you just throw all your cares away.
Yeah.
They,
yeah.
And then they got the la la la. You know, yeah. It's like a whole lot of singing. Man, I like this song, man.
Word.
Man, this album is tight, man.
For sure. John Bryan on the keys, Warren Campbell on the keys.
And this brother, is Rock? Is it Rock? What's his name?
Tony Williams, the singer?
No, something like I saw something.
Nas.
No, it says something like Rock.
Oh, the Rock is definitely in the building. So that when they talking about that, kind of even on the last song too, Diamonds, they're talking about Rockefeller Records.
Oh, okay. When they said, okay.
The Rock is definitely in the building. Yeah. And also like that song, the Diamond song, is like the Rock sign is throwing up a diamond.
See, and you know, I saw them doing that, and you know what I thought it was?
What?
A sign for Illuminati.
Yeah, that they tried to like make that.
Is that where that came from?
They try to like make the correlation that.
So how you do it like this?
Yeah, throw the rock up,
like that.
Yeah, we probably just joined the Illuminati.
I hope not.
No, but
well,
yeah, you know they always say like Jay-Z is in the Illuminati.
Yeah, I've heard that quite a bit.
Yeah, for sure.
So. He's even evaded to that in some of his songs. Like he denies it.
He references it, yeah, for sure. And I think they like even do stuff in their videos just to get people to keep saying it.
Just
because the more that people talk about it, the more.
Yeah. I get it. It just keeps him
relevant.
Yeah,
all that good stuff. All right, yeah. So that's We Major. That's my absolute favorite song from this album.
That's your favorite one?
Yeah, for sure.
Man, I got a lot of favorites on this one though.
Yeah. To me, I just love that Nas verse on there. I think Kanye kills his verse, and then just the music is just so beautiful.
Yeah, it is. It is.
And that driving, like, it's not a bass, but it's a bass. It's like, I don't know. It's just, oh man.
He uses a lot of piano.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Super dope. Love that song. All right, we'll go ahead and move on to skit number three, and then it's gonna roll right into Hey Mama. Skit number three is
I think I heard that. Was that on his documentary?
Yeah.
The Hey Mama.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So skit number three is Broke Five Broke is back. What do you think about the skits in Broke Five Broke and like what that means for the album?
It just reminds me of college days when, you know, I used to watch guys pledge, and you know they always hit the Sigmas and the Alphas and the Qs and the Kappas, and then to hear them go with they're talking about a fraternity called Broke Five Broke. And I'm like, damn, we ain't got no money, we ain't got no cars, we ain't got no hoes, we ain't got shit. Oh man, that's cool. They should have a fraternity like that.
A Broke Five Broke fraternity. Somebody should definitely make at least a skit, like a video skit of that, because that would be hilarious.
Yeah, that would be funny.
That'd be really funny.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So, Broke Five Broke is back, skit number three, and then we're gonna go right into Hey Mama, which you said you remember from the doc.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. And then that one is produced by. I'm assuming Kanye West and John Bryan again. Yep.
Right.
And that, you know what that one's about, so we'll just go right into it.
Here we go.
This was founded years ago by broke slaves years ago who did not have years ago. By broke brothers in the 20 years ago who did not have when we could not eat. Remember that? Eating all of our cereal with forks because we wanted to save the milk. Do you remember that?
Damn.
Do you remember all those Christmases when your mama walk in the room and pretend she was the tree? Huh? Remember that?
No.
My mom never did that.
Eating cereal with a fork doesn't save the milk.
Oh, man.
I want to scream so loud.
That's crazy.
Because I'm so proud of you. And let me tell you what I'm about to do. I know I act a fool, but I promise you I'm going back to school. I appreciate what you allow for me, and I just want you to be proud.
I
want to
tell the whole world about a friend of mine. This little light of mine, I'm finna let it shine. I'm finna take y'all back to them better times. I'm finna talk about my mama if y'all don't mind. I was 3 years old when you and I moved to the shy. Late December, harsh winter gave me a cold. You picked me up something that was good for my soul. Famous homemade chicken soup, can I have another bowl?
For me, I just want you to be proud.
Boys come, mama said, life is like a box of chocolates. My mama told me go to school, get your doctorate. Something to fall back on, you could profit with. But still supported me when I did the opposite. Now I feel like it's things I gotta get, things I gotta do, just to prove to you, you was getting through. Can the choir please give me a verse of you? Are so beautiful to me.
Nice.
Can't you see?
Pretty.
You're like a book of poetry. Maya Angelou, Nikki Giovanni. Turn one page and there's my mommy. Come on, mommy, just dance with me. Let the whole world see your dancing feet. Now when I say hey, y'all say mama. Now everybody answer me.
Come on, mama. I wanna scream so loud for you to go. Wrote this song just so you know, no matter where you go. My love is true.
Violin, man.
The violins, but it's a synth too, like a synthesizer on it.
Oh, yeah,
just making it sound like
because I was thinking that was the big cello. That's what I thought it was.
It's definitely a string, but then he's got it mixed with some kind of synthesizer that's doing the same exact thing as it.
Okay, yeah, it's moving, it's like it's carrying it somewhere. It's
like,
right.
All right, that's Hey Mama by Kanye West. That's track number 16. What did you think about that one, Dad?
You know what? There's one Mama song that always kind of touched me, and that was Boys and Men. Mama song that always touched me, you know? This one touched me the same way.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like, this is the hip hop, you know, but at the same time, man, that was a sweet song. That was nice. Hats off to Kanye on the Mama song.
Yeah, that was a big song. The other really big song off of here was Gold Digger.
Yeah.
That was like really big song. And then Touch the Sky was actually a pretty big single as well. But yeah, this song, just, you know, Mama songs are the best.
Yeah, they are.
You know, shout out to my mom. And
shout out to my mom. I just sent her a song.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was the Mama song, Boys and Men.
Oh, okay.
Because it was a birthday.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. You've heard the Tupac Mama song, haven't you?
I vaguely remember Tupac's.
Yeah, he's got a really good Mama song too.
Was that on the Tupac that we reviewed?
No.
It wasn't?
No.
We reviewed he had a double.
Yeah, All Eyes on Me. No, I think that's on.
I think I have that one though.
Yeah. All right. We'll go ahead and roll into the next track. This is track number 17 off of your Late Registration by Kanye West. This was produced by John Bryan and Kanye West. And get right into it. Here we go. Celebration.
Oh.
celebration, bitches. Grab a drink, grab a glass. After that, I grab your ass. Why you lacking on? Shine on. Wise y'all. Lying for. I never did this before. Stop that. What you want, some Patron? I got that. I mean, I promise y'all. You fine and all. And your girlfriend, she kinda raw. But she not like you. No, she not like you. Right now, I need you to mute all the monologue. All that talking is gone. You had me, yep, we was practicing. Till one day, your ass bust through the packaging. You know what, though? You my favorite accident. So go ahead, pop some Cristal for my newborn child. Cause now, yeah, know what this is.
You my favorite accident.
It's a celebration, bitches. Grab a drink, I'm grab crazy. A glass. After that, I grab your ass.
Oh, but
I
just start to
show. We hit the liquor store, got some Chris and some Mo, and we about to
nice.
Let it flow.
It's a nice song. Yeah.
Oh, had some problems before, but see, we let them go. Got an ounce that I drove, and we about to let it flow.
Celebration. That's one of my second. I think that's probably my second favorite song.
That was a really good song. It's so musical.
Yeah.
Yeah. He just does, and the things he does. I mean, the sampling and the way he's creative with using the sounds, different sounds and stuff. Man, he's just like, damn. How do you think of that? I guess he just sits around and just plays with shit.
Yeah.
You know, and just, oh yeah, let me see what this sound like.
Uh huh.
You know, but nice song.
I love the one of my favorite things about Kanye West music is just like he'll let a beat like ride out for like 30 seconds after the song is. Mm-hmm. Most people would have cut the song off already.
Right.
But he lets the beat go for a while and then he'll do something interesting with the instruments like at the end of a song that just. It just keeps the song interesting from the very beginning to the very end when it goes out. It's like those are some of my favorite parts. It's just like the little part he'll do at the end of a song.
Yeah, those harmonies.
Yeah,
those vocals, mm-hmm. the harmonies. Man, he has that in a lot of the songs on this album.
Mm-hmm.
Sweet, man.
Yeah, a lot of those background vocals are usually Tony Williams on these first two albums that we listened to. So Tony Williams is just like, oh man, I just love the way that he uses those background vocals to emphasize something he's saying or to bring out a hook. You know, shout out to Ye, man. This is awesome. Cool. All right, we'll go ahead and get into track number 18 and then 19. 18 is the skit number 4. We're going to get Broke 5 Broke one more time. And this is produced by Kanye West and D-Ray's playing the guy. Here we go. All
right.
Oh, and then the next song. Okay, so yeah, I would say my favorite songs off of here are probably We Major, Celebration, and then this next song, which is called Gone. Just like those three, like in like this part of the album, like toward the end, is like, oh man,
okay.
I just really like that little stretch in here. But yeah, skip 4 and then Gone features Consequence and Cam'ron. Consequence had a verse on Kanye's last album as well on Spaceship. Mm-hmm. GLC and Consequence were on that. So we're gonna hear Consequence again, and then you'll hear Cam'ron for the first time. Cam'ron is a Rockefeller artist from New York. He's from New York, and he works with Kanye. Kanye's produced on his projects, so he's pretty hot at this point in time. Okay. So he's another feature on this record, Gone. Skip 4 and then Gone. Here we go.
All right.
Call this private meeting today because there is a imposter among us. there's an imposter among us. This brother right here has been out making beats on the side. Uh-oh. Yes, he has. Pretending he's broke walking amongst us. This brother has been eating every day. Can you believe that? Eating every day. Pretending he's with us. He's not one of us. I did not want to believe this, but I walked into the brother Kanye's closet and I found new shoes. I found new shoes. Kanye, would you like to step forward and explain these new shoes? What's next?
We spy and told.
Oh, it's ready.
Only one.
Uh-oh.
But it's too late. It's too late.
You sweater, and I ain't talking about a Cool J. You a big L, and I ain't talking about Cool J. See me at the airport, at least 20 Louis. Treat me like the prince, and it's my sweet brother, Noomsay. Group to say I'm too choosy. Take him to the show and talk all through the movies. Says she want diamonds, I took her to Ruby Tuesdays. If we up in Fridays, I still have it my way. With a movie on, said he couldn't rap, now he at the top with Doobie Long. Cause the dookie don't any song that they do me on, gone.
We strive at home. I ride on chrome. We strive at home. Killer, I ride on chrome. Knock, knock, who's there? Killer Cam, killer who? Mm. Killer Cam, hustler, grinder, gorilla, troop, up my chinchilla, bro. You never dealt with a dealer, well, here's the deal. While we going to the dealer, boo. No concealing, no ceiling, I don't need a roof. Roof. Act up, get out, I don't need you, poof, poof. Be gone, damn, tough luck, dag, dag, dag. Niggas still doing puff, puff, pass. Pull the truck up fast, and I tell them, hey, back in the touched up jag shit. Boy, move on, that's your best bet. Why's that cause?
Yeah. I've been pouring out some liquor for the fact that my pal's gone. And trying to help his mama with the fact that a child gone. And since we used to bubble like a tub full of cow gone, guess it's only right that I should help her from now on. But since they got a foul on, what could have gone wrong? Now they asking cons, how long has this gone on? And maybe all this money might have gone to my head. Cause it got me thinking money might have gone to the Fed. So I ain't going to the dread, but he ain't going up to bed. And when I came the next morning, he was going my bread. And with that being said, I ain't going my instincts. And going to the spots where they go to get mixed drinks. But looking back now, I should have gone to the crib and rent and gone with the wind. Cause I'd have gone to my tent, but I ain't going my friend. And we had gone to the bar and heard a nigga talking shit, so I ain't going to the car. And now the judge is telling me that I ain't gone too far. And I'll be gone for 20 years doing time behind bars. And since I'm going to a cell for some petty crimes, I guess I'm going to the well one too many times. Cause I'm gone.
It's switching up.
Yeah. But the beats stay like the...
Yeah.
But the everything else is like switching. Yeah. Yeah, it's all
right. That's a trip.
It's all right.
Sometimes years out, so the powers that be won't let me get my ideas out. And that make me wanna get my advance out and move to Oklahoma and just live in my aunt's house. Yeah, I romance the thought of leaving it all behind. Kanye, step away from the limelight, like when I was on the grind in the 1999. Before model chicks was bending over. Oh, I'm no dream, but the inspiration is free. But if they ever flip sides like Anakin, you will sell everything, including the mannequin. They got a new bitch, now you Jennifer Aniston. Hold on, I handle it. Don't start panicking, stay calm. Shorty's at the door, cause they need more inspiration for their life, they souls, and they songs. They said, sorry, Mr. West is gone.
Wow.
All right, that is Gone, featuring Consequence and Cameron. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Man, that song had so many layers to it.
Yeah.
And it, like you said, it kept the same beat, but underneath it was kept on, it just kept the, I can't even explain it.
Like the arrangements would change and he was changing keys and
it would slow up and, you know, it would pick back up a little bit and it was just like, I don't know, man. It was like songs within songs or something. But the beat was constant.
Yeah. What'd you think about those guest verses? Cameron
did his thing.
He liked his verse on there.
He did his thing, bro.
Cameron's dope. I would love to play some Cameron for you for sure. He's a really dope rapper.
Yeah, he killed it on this one, that for sure. The parts he had. Yeah.
Hustle, that grinder, gorilla troop.
Yep, yep. I love that. I love that. I was like, oh, whoa.
Yeah, he was dope. And then Consequences verse is really dope because he actually really stuck to that gone theme. Like
right.
Almost every line in his verse
says gone. Gone.
Yeah. So yeah. I thought I was just real clever. His verse is super, super clever. And then Kanye's third verse on that one, what did you think about some of the stuff he was kind of reminiscing about how it was hard to get on? And
oh yeah, he's tripping. Just simple things, man, to me, like when he said, I'm gonna move to Oklahoma and just live in my aunt's house.
Yeah.
And I was like, damn, he probably got an aunt really that lives in Oklahoma. You know what I mean?
Right.
And he was talking about, yeah, I want to get home just one beat. Then I can get off this cheap ass sofa.
Yeah.
Kanye got off. His raps, his part in this one was just like, it was packed with a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
Man, so.
Yeah. Cool.
What did you like about this?
Oh, I love this whole song. Every part of the song. But yeah, I mean, if I can get one beat on Hova, I love that. there's so many lines. Kanye goes crazy on this one. And yeah. Great song, lots of different changes in it, and it just keeps the song interesting from beginning to end.
This one's added to the library.
Yeah, nice.
For sure. You know what? I told you when we first started, I said, man, I hope this don't be boring.
Yeah.
Man, this one was fun.
Word.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Classy rap album.
Classy rap album.
We'll be there.
We'll go ahead and move into track number 20. This is Diamonds from Sierra Leone. It's the actual original version of the Diamond song.
All right.
So this is produced by Davo Springsteen, John Bryan, and Kanye West.
Springsteen, is he?
In relation to
Bruce
Springsteen?
Mm-hmm.
No idea. Maybe.
I'm pretty sure it's some of the folk out there.
Yeah, maybe the commenters will let us know if
Devo Springsteen is
related to Bruce.
Could be his son.
Or maybe cousin, uncle.
Brother.
Who knows? Yeah. All right. So this one is with no Jay-Z verse, and Kanye's verses are different. Here we go.
Okay.
Diamonds are forever. They won't leave in the night. I've no fear that they might desert me. Diamonds are forever.
Throw your diamonds in the sky if you feel the vibe.
Diamonds are forever.
The rock is still alive every time I rhyme. Forever, ever, forever, ever, ever, ever. Magic Vegas on acid, seen through East Saint Laurent glasses, and I've realized that I've arrived, cause it take more than a magazine to kill my vibe. Does he write his own rhymes? Just sort of, I think that mean I forget better shit than you ever thought of. Damn, is he really that caught up? I ask, if you talking about classes, do my name get brought up? I remember I couldn't afford a Ford Escort, I even a Ford track recorder.
So
it's only right that I let the top chop on a drop top Porsche. For yourself, that's important. If you strip her name Porsche and you get tips from any man, then your fat friend, her nickname is Minivan.
Oh,
excuse
damn.
Excuse me, that's just the Henny, man. I smoke, I drink, I'm supposed to stop, I can't because. Throw your diamonds in the sky if you feel the vibe. The rock is still alive every time I rhyme. But the flow is anemic after debris settles and the dust gets swept off. Big K pick up where young folk left off. Right when magazines wrote Kanye West off. I drop my new shit, it sound like the best of. A&R's looking like we messed up. Grammy night, damn right, we got dressed up. Bottle after bottle till we got messed up. In the studio, we're really though, yeah, he next up. People asking me is I'm gonna get my chain back. That'll be the same day I get the game back. You know the next question, dog. Yo, where Dame at? This track the Indian dance to bring our rain back.
I like when he said that. Y'all okay, Indian man? Dance to bring our rain back. Yeah.
Like, right here stands amen with the power to make a diamond with his bare hands.
Diamonds are forever.
Throw your diamonds in the sky if you feel the vibe.
Diamonds are forever.
The rock is still alive every time I rhyme.
Yeah.
right, that is the original version of Diamonds from Sierra Leone. What'd you think about that one, Dad?
Great song. Great song. Kanye just be going off, man, on a tangent. Man. Just be like, just killing it.
You really like that rain dance line. I like that.
Yeah.
Do the Indian dance to bring our rain back. And it's just a kind of a little background on what he's referencing. At this time, Rockefeller Records is actually dissolving.
Oh, really?
So the three guys started Rockefeller Records are Jay-Z, Dame Dash, and Biggs Burke.
Mm-hmm.
And at this time, Dame Dash and Jay-Z were having disagreements,
mm-hmm.
and they were pretty much breaking up the Rockefeller label.
Oh,
so okay. Kanye, he's referencing, like, bring our rain back, the diamonds are forever, throw your diamonds in the sky. Mm-hmm. Like, he's kind of referencing the fact that maybe this is going through some trouble, but I'm gonna be the one that keeps Rockefeller alive. I'm
right.
gonna, you know, it's forever. Like, this is like so he references that a lot in his verses.
Oh, okay.
Just a little backstory on that.
Cool.
All right. Cool. So we'll go ahead and roll into the last song here, which is called Late. It is track number 21, produced by Kanye West.
That's next to the last, right?
Nope, that's the last one. Track number 21.
Oh, okay.
Produced by Kanye West. Late is the final track.
Excuse me.
Here we go.
All
right. Oh. You know that one?
Yeah.
I'll be late for that, baby, I wait for that. If you had a taste pain. For that, you probably pay for that. I'm coming in when I feel like it. To turn this motherfucker up only if it feels right. I'll be late for that, I can't wait for that. I think I was made for that. So I'm coming in when I feel like it. To turn this motherfucker up only if it feels right. Not even electus, not even prerequisite. You mean I missed my major by a couple of seconds? Now I'm in the shop class or the basket weaving with all the rest of the motherfuckers underachieving.
Damn.
Man, this is an insult. I went to junior high with all of them and they been slow. If I can catch the beat, then slow down the tempo. Just notice at the end if I'm too late for the intro. Well, I make it from the student loans to a benzo. Like old folks pissing, I guess it all depends. Oh, oh. You know when you be late, you miss all the lights. That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
And when you get back, she gon' start up a fight. That night.
That night.
That night. Baby, it's too late for that. Lately, I've been taking it slow. Trying to make it to the party for the guest list clothes. With the freshest hoes. The professors know. We about to get real. I'm professional. Like them Eskimos. What would you do for a Klondike?
Oh, no,
or two dykes that look Christina Milian.
That analog keyboard is so dope.
I know,
yeah.
Right?
All right, that is the conclusion of
just killed that
Late, and also the conclusion of the Late Registration album.
Late Registration.
Yeah.
Straight up in my collection today.
Yeah, awesome. So, Taker, you like that album?
I really liked it.
Would you compare it at all? How would you compare it, I guess, to the first Kanye West album that we listened to?
Totally different.
Mm-hmm.
But both of them were great,
mm-hmm.
even though they were totally different. Like you were when you were saying that Kanye, you know, none of his albums sound the same. Okay, so the first two I've heard, they didn't sound the same.
Mm-hmm.
But both of them were great. Now, see, this one is fresh up on me. So I'm saying right now that I like this one better than I did the first one. Mm-hmm. But then when I go back to the first one, I'm pretty sure I'm going to say, oh, damn, now I'm gonna talk. It's a toss up. Yeah. You know what I mean?
For sure.
So I didn't expect this. And that's the reason why this is like in my mind right now so good, because I was like, oh, hell, this ain't going to be good. Kanye two times in a row. And then he just, man, he just killed it.
Yeah.
And I like that that last song, Little Girl, Please Stop. Yeah, boy, that just like, that's an old school jam I have. I used to play a lot.
Yeah, I love that sample. Beautiful sample.
Nice sample. And then that keyboard.
Mm-hmm.
That keyboard was just like killing it near the end, you know? I was like, damn. And the keyboard just like mesmerized you.
Yeah.
It was like, you listen to all this music and you listening to him talk and rap. And then that keyboard and just messing with your mind.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Get you looped in.
Yeah, it does.
Uh-huh.
That was a nice album, Rod.
Awesome. So, yeah, I hope that you like revisit this and the other album as well, because I just think they're really dope bodies of work. And I think that like the biggest difference I feel like in this album from the last one is this one just sounds like more expensive. If you know, even watching the documentary too, like you could tell, like he was like making his penny stretch on the first album,
right?
Trying to get it done and put it out and do it himself. And Cootie's shooting the videos for him and stuff, and he's just like having to use the resources that he has,
right?
But then on this album, it's kind of like he got money now, he could just build on top of the sound that he kind of created on the first one. So yeah, just the production, the string section,
more quality, you think?
Yeah, like sound wise, yeah. Topic wise, I thought he was he came through like with dope topics just like the first album. He wasn't scared to speak his mind. He's bragging, he's also talking about real life issues. I don't know, this one is I don't know which one I like better. Honestly.
Well, I can say this. I remember when you were younger, man, you were Kanye crazy. And I was just like looking at you like, the hell? What's he so Kanye crazy? The hell, Kanye, you know? And now that I've visited Kanye and have a little bit more perspective on him, man, Kanye is deep, brother, man. I like him. I respect him. And I like his work.
Yeah.
Yeah, he puts in the work, too.
Yeah, and I think that's a big thing that separates his music from a lot of artists is just there's just so many levels. There's just so many levels and layers to his music. You know, he just really takes a lot of care into like making sure the music sounds great, but also making sure that he's like saying something. And he's also can say like cool rapper stuff and like kind of get into that bag. And just his music's great for like just boosting you up and just feeling like you can just do anything.
Yeah, and it's all detailed, man. It's like, it's just like, I don't know, man. It's like a surgeon, dude. He's so precise. He's like, man, you can tell that he puts in a lot of work. I mean, he's just not just going in the studio and playing.
Yeah.
He's putting in the overtime.
For sure.
For his, you know, when he produces something, he's going all in. You know, you could feel it from his music.
Some of the people that have worked with him, and I think even he's referenced the fact that like he'll like work on a song like 30 times.
Yeah.
Like a lot of rappers will go to the studio, cut a song, lay their verses, lay the hook, and then leave it and the engineer, you mix it and master.
Right.
But like Kanye, he'll like do the song, go listen to it in the car, go home, live with it. Oh no, it needs to, we need to put this, we need to do this. Like he'll go back and change lines, he'll go back and, you know, re-say stuff.
And you could feel it. You could tell, you know, because it's everything is like just a high level, just it's excellent. It's just excellent all the way through. This was a really good album, man.
Dope.
Really.
Cool. All right, guys. Well, that is Late Registration. Thank you for watching our video. If you like this and you want to see more, make sure you put a big old thumbs up on this bad boy. Also, drop a comment. Let us know what album we should react to next. Let us know what your favorite song off of Late Registration is. And please turn on your notification bell so you can be notified every time we drop a new video. Patreon coming soon. So, yeah, tap in with that too.
All right.
All right, guys. Thanks for watching. See you later.